Hi, I'm Lior, and I will present to you our recent work on multi-view neural surface reconstruction with implicit lighting and material. In this work, we address the challenging problem of multi-view 3D surface reconstruction. Given 2D images capturing a real object from multiple views, our goal is to infer the 3D geometry of the object, its appearance, and the cameras which capture those images. We present Implicit Differentiable Renderer, a neural network architecture that simultaneously learns those three unknowns. IDR able to produce high-fidelity 3D surface reconstruction by disentangling geometry and appearance, learned solely from mass 2D images and rough camera estimates. A recent successful neural network approach to solving this problem is by feeding those three unknowns into a differentiable rendering system, that is, simulate the rendering of the scene from a given view, and comparing the rendered image to the original image. The key challenge is how to make the renderer a function of the geometry that is independent of the object material or the scene lighting. A recent work by Nemer et al. Introduced such a differential rendering model that can represent arbitrary texture but cannot handle reflectance and lighting effects, nor can it handle noisy cameras. Concurrently to our work, NERFT used neural rendering for novel view synthesis from a set of images with known cameras, where differently from IDR, their method doesn't produce a surface reconstruction of the scene geometry rather than a three-dimensional density field. In our work, we reconstruct an implicit surface together with surface light field that is separated from the geometry, and we can handle both exact and noisy camera information. Our geometry is represented as the zero-level set of a neural network F, which model for each 3D point its sine distance function to the shape. Given a learnable camera position and some fixed image pixel, we would like to produce differentiable RGB values. The camera orientation and pixel define a viewing direction, and we can trace for the first intersection of the viewing ray with the implicit surface. The first step is to represent the intersection point and its normal as a differential function of the implicit geometry and the camera parameters. We implement it by simply composing the neural network with a fixed linear computation at its entrance and another at its output. Secondly, we want to approximate the color of the pixel, determined by the radiance reflected from the surface to the camera. Our interest is that the renderer will not memorize any part of the geometry or the viewing cameras. Therefore, we suggest representing the light field as a function of the surface position, surface normal, and viewing direction. This is implemented using a second neural network to output RGB values. Incorporating the normal and the viewing direction is necessary for 3D reconstruction that is decoupled from the appearance and the cameras. This claim can be explained using this simple example. A renderer without normal will produce the same light estimation in those two cases, therefore can result in a renderer that compensates over geometry properties. A renderer without viewing direction will produce the same light estimation in those two cases, where in real life the scene appearance is likely to be view dependent. To complete the IDR model, we introduce a global feature vector of the geometry to get our final radiance approximation, which then compared to the ground truth pixel color to simultaneously train the model's parameters. We apply our multi-view surface reconstruction model to real 2D images from the DTU dataset. Here, we show the reconstructed geometry, i.e. the zero-level set of the implicit function F, and rendering of novel views gained from the neural renderer M when using fixed ground truth cameras. Towards the goal of disentangling geometry and appearance, we show that we are able to transfer the appearance learned from one scene to different geometry by simply switch between the rendering networks. Note that without using the normal in the renderer, the geometry is not well approximated and the renderer fails to produce a plausible rendering of different geometries, although the light field approximation looks reasonable. Here are results in the setup of trainable cameras with noisy initializations. We show our surface reconstruction compared to the popular non-deep learning approach ColMap. We further show results of IDR training with fixed cameras set to the inaccurate camera initializations. This indicates that the optimization of camera parameters together with the 3D reconstruction is indeed significant. Here are some more results of our method. For more details, you're welcome to take a look at our paper. And stay tuned because our code and data will be available soon. Thank you for listening.